Welcome to another episode of Out and About in Cabarrus County. I'm Steve Morris, Cabarrus County Commissioner, and I have with me today Rosh and Yesenia from our budget department to talk a little bit about how our budget is developed and how that process works. Welcome. It's good to have both of you with me today. I guess one of the first questions is, once the budget is passed, which we have done for this year, what are the first steps going on to the next year? In other words, what will you be doing on July the 2nd?
Well, once the budget is passed, we're still working on making sure everything's where it's supposed to be. We're trying to make sure everything's implemented correctly. And then moving forward, we're monitoring the budget, making sure that things are coming on under the budget like we had planned, and also working on forecasting and other projections during the year. And then this coming year, we'll be working on introducing a new budget prep system, so that'll keep us busy all the way through September when we begin the budget process again.
That doesn't give you very much of a break. I mean, the budget really is a year-round process. Yesenia, what's your role in the process? Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, absolutely. At the end of the day, it's compiling the budget. Me and Rosh work very closely together to work with departments and outside stakeholders to make sure that we're getting the budget to you guys, which to be approved, the commissioners. But that's more than just getting it to you guys. Like you said, it's a very long process. It used to be shorter. We start now in September, so it's about a 10-month process to get it all put together from start to finish before we can actually hand you guys the recommended budget.
Yeah. Well, one of the favorite words that we like to use all the time across the board is collaboration. And tell me a little something about the collaborative nature of the budget process and how that all works.
The budget involves many, many stakeholders, and we have to collaborate with all of these stakeholders. So when I say stakeholders, I mean what I consider my clients. And so those would be all our various departments, all of the community partners, including the schools, the community college, the Health Alliance, and many, many other not-for-profit organizations.
I would also say specific departments that we collaborate with very closely are the finance department and tax administrators. In around February, we start forecasting out for what the year is going to look like. And so a collaboration plays a big part in our revenue forecasting and kind of where we see we're going to end the year, but also in the future for our five-year plans. We're working very closely with departments, but also state organizations to kind of get a balance of what we think is going to end up being our product.
Right. Yeah. One of the comments that I've made most frequently over the years is a lot of what you folks do in creating the budget and what we as elected officials do is a lot of crystal ball work, a lot of trying to predict the future and trying to project what's going to happen. And I think you do an excellent job with that. And you know, I think that this past year probably is a prime example of how unusual a year can be. I mean, although I think we did very well, certainly from a budget standpoint, but so many uncertainties and so many things that could not be predicted. Rosh mentioned our mission statement and our strategic plan, you know, and most people don't understand how that's tied together, that the decisions, the financial decisions that we make in the county are not just arbitrary and not just some individual's desires. It's all tied to that strategic planning process and the goals and the mission. And then the transparency piece is what I think is most important. And any citizen that has a question about any financial aspect of the county, it's all available for anyone to see. That budget book, I think it's probably one of the greatest information pieces that we produce in the county and really, really offers a lot to our citizens. What would you say is the most difficult aspect of your job?
I would say prioritizing the needs. We have so many needs and limited resources. And we're looking at the strategic plan as a guide for that. You know, we're looking at what are the priorities, the goals of the county, and are we meeting those, and what makes us meet those goals the best, and we're able to fund those areas. But again, the toughest part is saying no to somebody that has made a request.
Right.
And that's always tough.
Yeah. What would you say is the most rewarding part of the job?
For me personally, I think it's the community output, the outreach that we get to do. We didn't get to do as much of it this year. Luckily, in this last little bit, we've gotten a chance to really outreach and communicate with community members. But it's that part where we get to share, because like you said, it is a daunting thing to just look at the budget book and not be able to really understand what's making it up. But getting to actually go to the Gov 101 sessions and really see what their feedback is and taking that in, but also just being able to explain what's in the budget document.
Right. What would you say is the most misunderstood part of the process?
The most misunderstood part of the process, I think, is the feel that the budget director is making all the decisions. We're not. It's a collaborative process that involves many, many individuals providing input and then prioritizing those. So it's not a one-person decision. It's not the budget director saying no.
I think that's an excellent answer. Do you have anything you wanted to add to that?
Yeah, I was just going to say, I think lots of people think budget and they think boring, and hopefully we get to dispel that a little bit. It is a little bit boring. They think it's just me and Rosh back there with spreadsheets all day long. But as we've talked about a few times, it's a lot of collaboration. It's a lot of talking
right.
to different organizations, talking to the departments and the outside stakeholders. And so it's not all just numbers and boring.
Right. Well, as one of the commissioners that gets to vote on that final product, talk a little bit about the budget workshops.
I see the budget workshops as an opportunity for the commissioners to hear not only from staff, but also our external partners, the schools, the community colleges, the health alliances. It gives them a chance to interact with staff on their budget requests, but also the external community partners and what they're requesting, see what their justifications are for the budget increases, and ask any questions they would have.
Right. And I think that you bring up a very important part that the public needs to understand, is that we as elected officials do get that opportunity to have that interaction with all the different agencies, with you folks, to ask any questions that we might have about it. And also, we have the opportunity to throw out alternatives as well. I mean, you know, I could say to you, what if we reduce the tax rate by 5 cents? What is that going to impact? Tell me what we would have to cut in order to do that. And most people don't understand that we do have those kind of conversations, and we do look at those alternatives and say, okay, if we cut the tax rate, there are going to be some taxpayers are going to be happy about that. But are they going to be happy if we have to cut back on the hours of operation of our libraries? Or will they be happy if we eliminate some park projects? You know, I think it's important for people that might be watching this to understand just how seriously you folks take it, and our elected officials as well. How are some of the ways that people can find out more about the budget and the process?
I think them attending the Government 101 session that we put on provides them an opportunity to hear about how the budget process, how the budget comes together. Also, hear from key staff members on their budget needs and what's being funded this year. Also, hear from county leadership, interact with not only the budget team, key staff members, but county leadership, being able to ask questions and have their questions all resolved.
Right. Well, it's been my privilege to participate in some of those Government 101 sessions this year and in previous years. And one of the things that I noticed this year, based on my observation, is the folks came in to the day with some predetermined ideas on some things. And then by the end of the day, there was kind of the light bulb had come on. Okay, now I get it. I understand the process and what you're trying to do. And I think that's really valuable. And I hope that some of those folks that participated in that process, which is an investment of a day's time, we'll go back out and share that experience with other citizens. What does it say to you that we provide a number of opportunities for public input, and we have public hearings that are advertised in the newspaper, announced at our meetings. We go to great lengths to make people aware of it. And so at our public hearing for the budget this year, I think, if I remember correctly, we had one person to speak.
First of all, as regards to the budget, I wanted to be very complimentary of the communications and outreach that has been department and the government 101 session and all the different provided information online to help us understand the budget. And it's very open, transparent, makes it very easy to understand. So I just wanted to pass along, I'm sure you may hear other comments, but I just wanted to pass along a comment and a compliment as to how well I feel the county is run and how well you support the citizens of this county.
How do we interpret that? Does that mean, okay, you're doing a good job and we don't have any concerns? Or does that mean, as you said earlier, the process is boring and we're going to leave it to you guys to do it? Well, how would y'all interpret that?
Well, we'd hope it's a good sign, but in the same vein of asking kind of where people can find more information and transparency, our website's a great resource for that. And on our website, you can contact us through a bunch of different ways. They have the phone numbers and emails available there. So we'd hope that it is a sign that people have been able to reach out and contact and make their needs known before the public hearing, and they've gotten to go to those Government 101 sessions and have their questions answered there. We would very much love more participation in public hearings and to hear more people's thoughts and opinions and hope that helps us form what next year's budget will be.
Right, right.
If we had the boardroom fill up and you had people saying, hey, this is wrong, that's an indication that we're doing something that is not meeting their expectations. And for a public hearing to have one person show up, and that was a very complimentary comment that he made, tells us that hopefully we're doing the right job as far as transparency goes, keeping the budget process an open process, and hopefully that's also an indication of the confidence and trust that the public has in not only the staff here, but also the commission and the decisions they're making.
Great. And certainly it's our desire for that to be an ongoing process all throughout the year, to have that communication, to answer those questions, to display that transparency so that that there's never a situation where a citizen would read something in the newspaper and say, oh, wow, this is the first I've heard of this. And I think that's when people become uncomfortable, is when they don't know about things, don't understand things. And that's why we put so much focus on transparency and trying to make people feel comfortable to come forward with their questions or concerns. So much of the time it's like I mentioned about the Government 101. I think people say, get very concerned about something, and then when you answer their question directly and honestly, they say, oh, okay, now I understand. I know that's true with me, and I certainly ask an awful lot of questions of a lot of folks, and really appreciate that relationship. If there, as we close out this segment, if there was one thing one message you would want to get out to the public, what would that be?
That's a tough one. Definitely the line of communication's open. I'd want them to know that we are very much open to feedback and communication and anything and everything that we can talk to them about and answer questions about. We are very happy to do.
Great. Rosh, how about you?
Same here. I think we have a very transparent process. If they have questions, our phones, emails are always available to them. Feel free to ask us questions. We want them to participate and be involved in the process that makes for a better budget product for us. One of the things, just as a quote of a very famous person, he said, "Don't tell me about your about what you value. Show me your budget and I'll tell you what you value." It speaks volumes about the budget document, and we're hoping to produce a budget document that reflects the values of the county.
Great. That's an excellent quote and just exactly what I would expect from a budget director. So I appreciate that. And so I want to thank both of you for taking the time to be with me today, and hopefully we've shared some information with our viewers that will make them be more engaged and more involved in the budget process and maybe ask some additional questions. So it's certainly been a pleasure to talk with you today, and I hope you get a little bit of a break since we've passed that budget and before we begin on the process for the next one. But it's always a pleasure to bring you another episode of Out and About in Cabarrus County, and we hope to see you back here again soon.